Welcome back to the final episode of CCDV at ChemCon Asia 2019, with today an interview on communication in the supply chain, a statement on Taiwan, a few more Seoul stories, and we'll start with Rudy Wilden with some quotes from yesterday's sessions on Europe.
We had a remarkable morning session with Eckart presenting on the next steps to be taken, which are big steps towards integration of all the data they collected and looking at it in a holistic approach, doing a grouping approach and finding out which are the substances of priority and which are the substances to be substituted. So a number of lists is going to evolve from this process and will have an impact on us all for sure.
Today's presentations clearly demonstrated that the authorization process is working. However, please take into account a clear definition of use is needed and also a clear description of what's actually being done. And that under current legislation also the bar is raised for the letters of alternatives which can contain no uncertainties.
Okay, when I was giving my presentation this morning on authorization, one of the things which I didn't get to mention was about the plans we have in ECHA to remodel and make the authorization process more efficient. And the intention is that we should be able to handle high peaks of applications for authorization without too much problems in the future. So we're looking at various mechanisms, for example, to relook at the opinion templates to make them more easily communicable to the person who has to read them. And we're also looking at ways in which we can group opinions which have similar processes and handle them together while giving each one of them the individual attention that it's need.
Time to go to our local reporter. Heung-jung, you already showed us several faces of Seoul. Anything in particular you'd like to share with us for the last bulletin this week?
Teared, I have many more faces of Korea I still like to show you. Especially these Haito masks. They're traditional Korean masks dating back to 12th century. They are believed to have spiritual powers.
The Hawatal masks, they are used during the Hawe Bulshingut, a mask performance conducted as part of shamanist rituals. The 12 masks represent the characters needed to perform all the roles like Sonbi the teacher and Bune the concubine.
Thank you for being our Sonbi this week. Later in this bulletin, I'd like to hear from you some recommendations for places to visit in Seoul.
I'm currently at the Hanok village. This is already a location I would recommend you visiting. It's close to the hotel on north side of the Namsan Mountain.
This village has restored traditional Korean houses, remodeled after the traditional houses of Joseon Dynasty, and show a range of social classes from peasants to aristocrats.
Hanok village is a great way to discover Korean culture aspects like folding hanji, and Taekwondo and Yunori, a Korean game.
Once again, thank you for being our teacher on Korean culture. More teachers in today's interview on supply chain communication. Reach introduced the extended SDS to focus on actual exposure scenarios by making risk assessments for specific uses. How does this enable the safe handling of hazardous materials?
Well, basically the idea behind the exposure scenario is to develop activity-specific safe use advice. That's the fundament of it. If you look prior to REACH, larger companies receiving or handling chemicals, they would typically invest in performing their own risk assessment and developing worker safety advice, also ensuring environmental safety. So they would take the information they receive from their suppliers on the hazard, their knowledge of their own uses and their customers' uses, and they would develop advice. The problem with that is that in smaller companies, SMEs, it can be difficult to find the resource or the expertise for that. So the whole idea of REACH is that the manufacturer, the importer, is best placed to understand and generate hazard information and should always also be best placed to understand their portfolio, the way their substances are used, and to perform that risk assessment top down.
Alberto, are you currently able to reuse and translate all the information that's provided to you via supply chain for other purposes like storage, permits, transport, etc.?
Sure. All this information will help us to prevent, mitigate, or anticipate any risk linked to the dangerous goods or hazardous materials that we receive or we handle. For transport, for example, because this information is going to be critical to define the transport classification, how you need to ship your goods. For storage, because you want to know the hazards of the products that you are going to store together, right? Or for handling, you know, to define the proper work conditions, you know, to assign, if required, the personal protective equipment, or for any additional permits that you may require according to the local legislation.
Please watch the complete interview on our website and YouTube channel. Now it's time for the statement of the day. Also in Taiwan, supply chain communication is essential. With us at CCTV today, Doris Tsai from SATEC. Doris, great to have you here.
Thank you, dear. I'm so glad to be here.
Doris, for the Taiwan registration process, supply chain communication is essential. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us how the confidential business information is protected then?
Yes, but the first thing I want to mention is that industry has the responsibility to protect our workers, consumers, and users. Of course, this their responsibility to make sure their products are safe. But in registration system in Taiwan, we do have the business information protection application procedure in place. Just communicate well with your local importers and make best use of those TPRs.
And your statement is?
The Taiwanese registration process offers a good solution to protect CBI.
Doris, thank you very much for being with us this week. Time to say farewell to our local reporter. Hanjun, what are your recommendations for people to visit in Seoul?
I would suggest visiting one of the palaces or go to Namsan Mountain, a nice walk through the park from the hotel.
Or we take this cable car. Please join me to the fast ride. Once you're on top of the mountain, I suggest you to take the elevator, where you can enjoy 360 degrees panoramic view of Seoul.
Yes, Namsan is a really nice and relaxing place to visit. Before we finalize with this report, can you do one more animal cafe?
Of course, you thought you had seen it all. But the most extraordinary cafes in Seoul is the Meerkat Cafe.
Like in all other cafes, there are strict rules to protect the animals. So, you don't have to worry about animal welfare.
Trust me, the life of a local reporter is much harder. But I enjoyed every minute of it. From Seoul, South Korea, it was Hyunjung for CCTV.
Thank you very much. It almost seems the Meerkats are already looking forward to ChemCon the Americas 2020. This morning we will focus on improving safe use in the supply chain with risk management measures, SUMI, emergency management and poison centers. In the afternoon we take a closer look at Japan and Taiwan and our grand finale, hazard communication and the practical implementation of GHS. Thank you for watching, we hoped you liked it and we look forward to seeing you in Philadelphia.